Hello, my dear students. Welcome back to chemistry class. Today, let us learn the lesson acids, bases, and salts. In this lesson, today we are going to cover the topics acid-base indicators, olfactory indicators, reactions of metallic oxides with acids, reaction of non-metallic oxides with bases. So let us see, what are acids? What are their properties? You have learnt in your lower classes about acids and bases. Can you say few vegetables and fruits which contain acids? Yes, tomato, orange, lemon, tamarind, all these contain acids. What are the taste? They taste sour. So we can say acids are sour to taste. And if we dip a blue litmus paper to an acid, it turns red. So acid turns blue litmus red. So we can say acids are sour to taste and they turns blue litmus red. Now what about bases? You know, bases are bitter to taste and turns red litmus blue. You are familiar with the substance, basic substances, or washing powder, washing soap, soaps, all these are basic in nature. So bases are bitter to taste and it turns, if you dip a red litmus paper to a base, it turns blue. So bases turns red litmus blue. Now let us see. We have seen now the litmus paper changes its color in acid and base. So let us see, this is an example for an indicator, acid base indicator. Let us see what is meant by an acid base indicator. Acid base indicators are dyes or mixtures of dyes which are used to indicate the presence of acids and bases. These indicators are classified into two types, natural indicators and synthetic indicators. So let us see a few examples for natural indicators. Litmus, red cabbage leaves, turmeric, colored petals of flowers such as hydrangea, petunia and geranium. You might be familiar if curry falls on your clothes, white, if it is white cloth, if you are washing with the soap, we can see it turns reddish brown color. That means the turmeric is an acid-base indicator. It shows different color in acidic and basic substances. So natural indicators, examples, litmus, red cabbage leaves, turmeric, colored petals of flowers such as hydrangea, petunia and geranium. Now let us see examples for synthetic indicators, phenolphthalein and methyl orange. Now let us see, what are the colors of these solutions? That means litmus paper, litmus solution, phenolphthalein and methyl orange in acidic and basic and neutral solutions. First, let us see what is the color of litmus solution in acids, bases and neutral solutions. So, neutral solution, litmus solution's color is purple. In acidic solution, it turns red, and in basic solution it turns blue. So litmus solution, the color of color in neutral solution, it is purple. Acidic solution, it is red, and basic solution, it is blue. Alkali means they are bases. Bases which are soluble in water, they are called alkalis. Next, let us see what is the color of phenolphthalein indicator in acids, bases and neutral solutions. So phenolphthalein in neutral solution, it is colorless. In acidic solution also, there is no color change. It remains as colorless. But in basic solution, its color changes to pink. So phenolphthalein indicator, its color in neutral solution, it is colorless, no color. And acidic solution also, it remains the same as colorless. And in basic solution, it turns to pink. Next, let us see what is the color of methyl orange indicator in acids, bases, and neutral solutions. Methyl orange, its color is orange in neutral solution. In acidic solution, its color changes to red. And in basic solution, its color changes to yellow. So, in acidic solution, methyl orange color is red, and in basic solution, it is yellow. Now, let us summarize all these three indicators, litmus solution, phenolphthalein, and methyl orange in acidic, basic, and neutral solutions. Litmus solution, its color is purple in neutral solution. It changes to red in acidic solution, and it changes to blue in basic solutions. Phenolphthalein, it is colorless in neutral solution. It remains as colorless in acidic solution, but it changes to pink in basic solution. Methyl orange, it is orange in color in neutral solution. In acidic solution, its color changes to red, and in basic solution, its color changes to yellow. Now let us see what are olfactory indicators. To understand the olfactory indicators, there is an activity. This is given in a textbook. Take some finely chopped onions in a plastic bag along with some strips of clean clothes. Tie up the bag tightly and leave overnight in the fridge. The cloth strips can now be used to test for acids and bases. Take two these cloth strips and check their odor. Odor means smell. Keep them on a clean surface and put a few drops of dilute HCl solution on one strip and a few drops of dilute NaOH solution in the other. Rinse both the cloth strips with water and again check their odor. Note your observations. So what you have to do? We have to take a few finely chopped onions and it should be kept in a plastic bag along with some strips of clean clothes. And keep it in the fridge overnight, one night full. Then the cloth strips, now we can use as an indicator for acids and bases. Now what we have to do? We have to take the two cloth strips and check their order. What order they will have? They will have the order of onion. Now what we have to do? We have to keep these two cloth strips on a clean surface. One of the cloth strips, we have to put a few drops of dilute HCl solution. What is HCl? Hydrochloric acid. The other strip, we have to put a few drops of dilute NaOH. NaOH is sodium hydroxide, that is a base. So again, we have to rinse both the cloth strips in water, with water, and again check their order. What we can observe? The solution, the cloth strip in which sodium hydroxide is put the drops of sodium hydroxide, we cannot detect the odor of onion in that. But the solution, the cloth strip in which we put the drops of HCl, that cloth strip, the smell of onion remains. So this is used as an acid-base indicator. Olfactory indicator means from the smell, we can identify whether the substance is an acid or a base. Now the same way, take some dilute vanilla essence and clove oil and check their odor. You're familiar with the vanilla essence, ice cream flavor, all you will get in vanilla flavor, and this that is having a nice smell, characteristic smell, and you're familiar with the clove also. So now take some dilute HCl solution in one test tube and dilute NaOH solution in another. Add a few drops of dilute vanilla essence to both test tubes and shake well. Check the order once again and record changes in the order. So what we have to do? We have to take two test tubes. In one test tube, add dilute HCl, that is an acid, and the other test tube, add dilute NaOH, sodium hydroxide, that is a base. What we have to do then? We have to add a few drops of dilute vanilla essence to both the test tubes and shake well. So here we can see the NaOH solution to which we have added the vanilla essence. There the smell of vanilla essence vanishes, or we cannot detect the smell of vanilla essence in that solution. The other solution where HCl is taken and we have added vanilla essence there we can detect its smell. it remains, the smell remains the same. So from this we can identify which is a base and which is an acid. Same way we can do this experiment with the clove oil also. Take two test tubes and a few drops of clove oil, add to both, in which one dilute HCl is taken, the other dilute NaOH is taken. Here also we can observe the same thing, that where the sodium hydroxide we have added the clove oil, there we cannot detect its smell, clove oil smells. The other one where the HCl is taken and we have added clove oil, there we can detect the smell of clove oil. So these all are called olfactory indicators. That means from the smell, its smell varies in acidic and basic solutions. Now let us see what are olfactory indicators. An olfactory indicator is a substance whose smell varies depending on whether it is mixed with an acidic or basic solutions. So we have seen the examples now: onion, clove oil, vanilla extract. All these are examples for olfactory indicators. So we have seen now different types of indicators, natural indicators, examples also we have seen, and synthetic indicators, methyl orange and phenolphthalein. And we have seen this litmus solution, phenolphthalein and methyl orange, the color change in acidic and basic solutions. And we are also seen what is meant by an olfactory indicator and there and its examples. Next, let us see reactions of metallic oxides with acids. So here is an activity. Take a small amount of copper oxide. Here we have taken which metallic oxide we have taken here? Copper oxide we have taken. Copper oxide in a beaker and add dilute hydrochloric acid slowly while stirring. So copper oxide, that is black in color, that we have taken in a beaker, to that what we have added? Dilute hydrochloric acid slowly we have added while stirring. So what we can see here? What is the color of the solution? And what happened to the copper oxide? So we can see here, the color of the solution becomes blue-green and the copper oxide dissolves. So the reaction takes place between copper oxide and HCl. Why the color is changed to blue-green? Because of the formation of copper chloride. So we can write the equation now. Copper oxide, CuO, plus HCl, hydrochloric acid, gives copper chloride, CuCl2 plus H2O. This copper chloride is blue-green color. To balance the equation, here 2 chlorine and 2 hydrogen. So we have to write here 2 HCl. So how we can write the general reaction now, general equation? So here copper oxide is a metallic oxide and hydrochloric acid is an acid. So when a metallic oxide react with an acid, we are getting a salt. Here the salt is copper chloride and water. So we can write the general equation as metal oxide plus acid gives salt plus water. So you have already learned in your lower classes, acid when react with bases will get salt and water. So it is similar to the reaction. Base plus acid gives salt plus water. So we can say from this, metallic oxides are basic in nature. Metallic oxides are basic oxides. So we have learned now the reaction of metallic oxide with acids. How we have conducted the experiment? A little copper oxide is taken in a beaker. To that, HCl solution is added drop by drop, slowly by stirring. And we can see the color of the solution changes to blue-green because of the formation of copper chloride. So here copper oxide reacts with HCl to form copper chloride and water. That means the general reaction is metal oxides react with acid to get salt and water. So from this reaction we can understand that metallic oxides are basic oxides. Next we are going to learn the reaction of non-metallic oxide with a base. So here we have taken the example of reaction of calcium hydroxide. You know, whitewashing. How the whitewashing is? Whitewashing, how it is done? A white color powder, that is a calcium hydroxide, that is mixed with water. So we'll get the slaked lime there. The slaked lime, calcium hydroxide is a slaked lime that is mixed with water. We'll get calcium hydroxide solution, that is called the lime water. So this lime water is applied on the walls. Afterwards, we can see white deposit is over the walls. So what is the reaction taking place here? This lime water or calcium hydroxide, it reacts with the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, in the air. And a white substance called calcium carbonate is formed here. So calcium hydroxide or lime water, that is a base. Calcium hydroxide is a base. Reacts with carbon dioxide to produce salt and water. We can write the equation as CaOH twice plus CO2 gives CaCO3 plus H2O. So how we can write the general reaction now? Calcium hydroxide is a base. So a base plus, you know, carbon is a non-metal. So carbon dioxide is a non-metallic oxide gives. So a base plus non-metallic oxide gives calcium carbonate is a salt. Salt plus water. So we can write the general equation as base plus non-metallic oxide gives salt plus water. You have already seen base and acid react, we are getting salt and water in neutralization reaction. Already you have learned this. So this equation is similar to base plus acid to form salt and water. So base is reacting with acid. That means non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. So here we have seen now metallic oxides are basic in nature. So metallic oxides, when react with acids, we are getting salt and water. And non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. That means non-metallic oxide, when react with a base, we are getting salt and water. So let us see what are the topics we learned today. We have learned acid-base indicators. Two types of acid-base indicators we have learned. Natural indicators, that is present in nature. Example for that, red cabbage leaves, turmeric, colored petals of some flowers such as hydrangea, petunia and geranium. And we have learned other types of indicators, synthetic indicators. That means artificially we have made. Example for this, phenolphthalein and methyl orange. Then we learn olfactory indicators. What are olfactory indicators? Their smell or odor varies in acidic and basic solutions. Example for that, onion, vanilla and clove oil. Then we learn the reaction of metallic oxides with acids. We are getting a metal oxide react with acid. We are getting salt and water. Example for that, copper oxide react with HCl. We are getting copper chloride and water. Reaction of non-metallic oxides with a base. Base plus non-metallic oxide, we are getting salt and water. So, example for this, calcium hydroxide, CaOH twice, react with carbon dioxide, we get calcium carbonate, CaCO3 plus H2O. So, from these two reactions, we can understand that metallic oxides are basic in nature and non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. Hope you understood today's class. Thank you, children.